We're going to learn how to make a health bar in After Effects. First, we're going to add a text. This is called Scout Bold. First, we're going to go 30 frames out, add a keyframe, and then at 1 second, we're going to change the value to 90. And then we're going to add a solid, create a little mask, and then we're going to animate this mask right when the value changes, and we're going to decrease the mask to make it look like the value went down. So you should have a little animation like this. If you want to make it smoother, just go into value graph, make it kind of like Bezier. Now go and make a solid and add the element plugin onto the solid. You're going to go into custom text and mask. Path layer 1 is going to be the mask and 2 is going to be the solid. And then you're going to make the mask into path layer 1. A little window should open up and then you're going to press extrude. We're going to go into bevels and then make extrude to add some depth. Control D to duplicate it, and then instead of custom path 1, we're going to make it custom path 2. We're going to change it so the layer is all kind of aligned, and then we're going to create a new folder and create the mask 2 and put it in the second folder. That way each is on its own respective layer. Now as you play the animation back, it's not going to be completely aligned. How we fix this is we're going to go into group 1, change the position of the bar right when the value changes to 90, and then we're going to go 30 frames out and kind of keyframe it all the way back so it's in line with the 90. And it's not going to be completely smooth, so we're going to have to bezier it, move the tail all the way down to the left so it's kind of smooth as you play it through. Now to animate the entire thing, we're going to go into world transformation to edit both at the same time. Kind of add a little transformation on the rotation and then set an initial keyframe outside of the screen, go 30 frames out and to set a secondary keyframe so it kind of appears into it. Add a easy end, that way it looks a little bit smooth, and then to make it look good, we're going to add ambient occlusion, make it ray traced, shadows, we're going to enable it and make it ray traced, and then in lighting, to make it really bright, we're going to make 100% ambient. And here is what our animation should kind of look like. If you want to make it look better, we can add some sort of stroke and increase the value on it. And if you want to make it really realistic, we can add some drop shadow. Just make sure that you pre-compose the element 3D layer, that way it's not impacting it. If you want to make it look even better, you can add Shadow Studio 2, add the distance 500, softness 400, start is 3, and end is 8. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you very soon.